Good morning. It is Sunday morning, and we're up and at them a little early. It's like 5:30 in the morning, because Tegan went down for a nap yesterday afternoon. What would you say, like around 2:30, 3 o'clock?
Yeah, we put him in his crib around 2:30. He was up for probably an hour in his crib, kind of
chilling out.
Chilling.
Yeah, he wasn't screaming or fussing. He was just kind of chilling out because he was tired. At the same time, I was taking a power nap. I slept for maybe an hour, and I assumed Tegan, oh, he'll wake me up. We usually nap around the same amount of time on nap days. But he kept sleeping, and he kept sleeping. And it was like past supper time. And
there's that moment where you're like, I should have woken him up, I think. But we didn't.
We thought for sure he was going to wake up like at 1:30 or 2:30 in the morning and just be a bundle of energy. But he slept all the way from 3 in the afternoon yesterday to 5:15 in the morning today. And now he's super hungry, had a super full diaper, and he is raring to go. So, yeah, since we don't have any food, we're going to hop in the car, see what we can find for breakfast. Let's go. You ready to go, Tegan? You ready to go have some food?
Let's go.
So we're on the road, time for a Ben and John road trip.
Again,
we're heading to New Hampshire. Again, like the third time in like 2 weeks. Crazy, I think this is a new record.
I think so, we're putting a lot of miles on this car.
So, yeah, like I said last night, Ben's friend in New Hampshire, who we don't see too often, her daughter is turning 3 years old, and they're having a little get-together today, and we were invited. Tegan hasn't seen her in a long time. I honestly don't know if Tegan's seen her or not before.
He has, but he was really little, so he's not gonna remember.
Like a little peanut size?
Yeah, we met up for dinner one night.
Oh, that's right, that's right. Because you were still pregnant when we went to her house.
Yes.
I remember now. That's when we got the little bouncer seat, the little jungle bouncer seat thing.
Yep.
Anyway, I also have a story to tell. You know, earlier we went to McDonald's and had breakfast. Because that's like the only thing in town that was open that early in the morning. And I brought the camera in with me. And you guys are lucky that you're seeing a vlog right now. Because I brought the camera in. And then I swung the camera on I had it over my shoulder. And then I put it on the back of my seat. And then when we got done eating, Tegan crawled under the booth, under the table. So I gathered up Tegan and made sure he had Simba and his bottle and everything. But guess what I forgot hanging on the back of the seat?
The camera.
We got all the way home and I came in and I was like, where's the camera? Luckily that nobody else was in that McDonald's except for one guy who was watching Tegan being a little goof while he was eating his pancakes.
And he was still there when John went back.
Yeah, he was keeping an eye on our camera bag. He'd be like, I knew you'd be back. He didn't really say that, but he gave me that look. It's like...
I didn't even know he brought the camera into McDonald's.
Well, I brought it in just in case, you know. Mm-hmm. We're vlogging all the time.
I know.
You know, you never know when something interesting's gonna happen.
Yeah.
But nothing interesting happened, and I forgot it was on the back of the seat. I was making sure Tegan had all his stuff. So anyway, we have our camera back. Phew. All right, let's hit the road.
All righty.
Stay tuned soon. We're gonna have another installment of Everything in Maine is Closing.
We are. We are. It's gonna be a special one.
It's gonna be kinda sad.
Well, kinda sorta.
Kinda sorta. We should be more broken up than we are about this.
But we're not.
And we'll tell you why when we're there.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we're taking a quick stop to document this latest edition of Everything in Maine is Closing. The latest victim here in South Portland, Maine.
Bugaboo Creek.
Bugaboo Creek Steakhouse abruptly closed 2 or 3 days ago. They had closed the location abruptly about a week before, I think last Tuesday in Bangor, and there's a newspaper article where it says, oh, the manager of Portland said there's been no word if they were closing the South Portland location.
And they were sending stuff to South Portland,
yeah,
correct?
Yeah, they were sending surplus food from Bangor's restaurant to South Portland's restaurant, and then with an abrupt phone call over 20 years here in South Portland came to a close. Now, if you're not familiar with Bugaboo Creek Steakhouse, it's a chain of restaurants, like a chain restaurant. Their gimmick was it looked like a like a woodsy type hunting lodge.
Yeah, it was like a hunting lodge. They were, it was, had a lot of Canadian outdoorsy type decorations and pictures. You know, there were snowshoes on the wall and deer antler light fixtures and stuff like that.
And they had animatronic animals like on the wall that would occasionally pop up, like a fish that would flop around or a raccoon that would pop out of a barrel.
And a goose with the head would turn.
And yep, and they had a big Christmas tree that would, you know, the eyeballs would open and it would start to talk. And they had a mounted, like, buffalo, like, build a buffalo here. Mm. It was kind of more in the vein of Rainforest Cafe as opposed to Chuck E. Cheese.
Yeah.
Even though the mounted heads on the wall were kind of reminiscent of the mounted heads on the wall at Disney World's Country Bear Jamboree. Mm. But anyway, I guess a couple years ago, I don't know if it was like because of maintenance or they wanted to attract a more mature clientele, they shut down the animatronics. They were still up on the walls, but they never turned them on anymore. Mm-hmm. I'd say that was probably the beginning of the end for Bugaboo Creek. And the last time we were at Bugaboo Creek, one of our favorite things on the menu was the snowbird chicken.
Yeah, we'd either have the snowbird chicken salad or the snowbird chicken platter.
They were basically chicken strips that they had this coating on it, this light crispy
like a,
coating.
Yeah, but like a light fluffy coating.
It was so good, but the last time we had it, they changed it so they were just like generic frozen chicken strips that you get like anywhere, like Applebee's or Friendly's. So it's like, well, no sense making a trip out of our way for it. I think we actually ranted about this in an old vlog.
I think so.
If you can find that vlog, leave a comment down below. I don't remember if it was a daily one or when we were doing just random sporadic ones.
I don't remember when it was.
But anyway, we're approaching it right now. We're gonna see if they've torn everything down or not, but stay tuned. Here we go. Pulling in real quick to see the remains of Bugaboo Creek. All this will be torn down soon. There are signs in the window. We have closed for business. All this will be gone soon. Poor old Bugaboo. They had really good landscaping. That's beautiful. Was there a moose statue out?
Yeah, the moose is gone.
Yeah, it looks like somebody's already destroyed that bench. That's a shame.
But yeah, there used to be.
Oh yeah, in the garden there used to be a moose statue right there.
Yeah, moose statue somewhere.
Yeah, you can see
right
the spotlights right here. Yeah. I think it was around here. The moose is in that dumpster now. I was commenting on their landscaping. It's really
nice. It's very nice, yeah. It's very well themed.
So there's a sign right there. Well, we'll always have the good memories of Bugaboo before they changed the chicken strips and all the animatronics were still singing and telling bad jokes.
That is true. Oh well, another thing down. Nothing bites dust.
I'm a bad vlogger. I missed crossing the New Hampshire Bridge. But we are in New Hampshire now. But you guys have seen it like 3 times now.
This week.
Yeah. Like, oh, they're going over the bridge again.
Yeah, here we go.
Quite a bit of traffic on this
Sunday.
There's
a lot of traffic today. Holy smokes. Like, I have to go pee, but I don't want to go off the highway because I don't want to have to deal with getting back on it.
Let's see, we're about an hour out from our Disney outlet, so
yeah.
We're going to have to stop someplace.
I know.
So we're still on the open road, guys. I got a question for you. Have any of you seen the Independence Day movie that opened up this weekend? Which didn't open up over Independence Day weekend. I've heard kind of like reviews about it. I still want to see it. I don't know if I'll see it in theaters or if it'll be like one of those things you pick up on Black Friday on Blu-ray for like $10.
It probably will, only because, you know, we have limited
movie time,
but
We also want to see Ninja Turtles and Finding Dory and Independence Day, but out of those three, Finding Dory is one that...
Yeah, that's our priority when it comes to movies. And then Turtles is after it.
Yep, we're hoping to see Dory on Wednesday if all goes according to plan.
If everything goes okay.
But you never know what's going to pop up between the house stuff and Tegan's nap schedule and just life in general gets in the way.
Yeah.
Movies get pushed to the back burner.
Yeah, they do.
Also, have any of you ever... done an Uber car before?
We've been talking about it.
Yeah,
Uber.
Yeah, we were just talking about it. We were thinking when we get to Schaumburg, we'll take an Uber from the airport, O'Hare Airport, to our hotel. We'll have to download the app and everything. We have to join the 21st century at some point. Last year we had kind of a stressful taxi ride.
It was scary.
Our driver wanted to get us to that hotel pretty badly. He was like cutting through construction cones, cutting people off.
We thought we were gonna die from a road rage incident because people were like flipping him off
and
yelling. And
take exit 2 to our downtown.
Scary.
So we're like thinking this year we'll try Uber. But have you guys had good experience with Uber? Everybody talks about Uber. Everybody raves about it. So I think we're gonna try it out, and I hope we like it.
So we'll either make it to the hotel or we won't.
Stop off at a Walmart. They have a game room, and Tegan wants to ride in this Bob the Builder truck.
And I think I have quarters. Yeah, I'll see if I have any. Yep.
Yay, Mama has some quarters.
Oh, yay! Here you go.
Oh, that's a dollar.
Here we go. I have 2 quarters.
There we go.
Oh,
hey,
there you go.
Okay. Okay, hit the button. Here we go. Oh, don't slide down. Aww. You don't want to ride in it? It's okay, bud. What do you think? Do you think I can knock this fuzzy tablet cover into this chute?
You have it? Yeah, maybe.
Okay, I'm gonna try. I have a one in my wallet. Man. The one he doesn't want to ride, it goes on forever. That Big Bird airplane, I think, goes for like 15 seconds. It's like going through the whole Bob the Builder song. He's using these Chinese food boxes in here.
I don't want to waste our money on those, buddy.
He's probably gonna fail. Okay, here we go.
I'll put you up there in a minute, buddy.
Okay, what do you think? From this angle, do you think I can knock it in?
Yeah.
Like right here?
Yeah, try right there.
Right. Let's move it, move it.
You want to ride the motorcycle? Okay. All right.
One.
it does. Both of them.
We're still at the age where he doesn't know there's no quarter. You think he'll drive a real motorcycle when he's older?
I don't know. Alright, bud. There's a quarter stuck in both of them.
They're in there good. Okay, Ben, get it.
I'm not gonna get it. Look at what happened. Oh, I can't get any of those, sweet pig. Look at how tiny those are. Look how tiny they are. You want me to try? Let's see if I have another quarter. But if not, maybe I could fish another one out of the motorcycle machine. Alright, one try, okay? We're gonna try once and then we're gonna go. Alright. That's where the quarter goes. Okay.
Okay. Go. Probably closer to the edge the better, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, get ball.
Oh, at least it sort of grabbed it.
Alright, sweet pea, we didn't win.
Yep.
Look what they have. They have the Monster High Minis and they have the Mini Mixie Cubes. Oh my gosh. I stole one. I don't know if we're going to get any though. But they have them here, so that's a good sign. That means they're making their way to Maine. Yay!
You see this Mickey? He's on a bike.
Hiya, pal! Let's play Follow the Mickey! Cycle spin!
No. Ever After High, Monster High. Same old pony stuff. Nothing new. Oh well. Deegan, come back this way. They have a girl teddy friend. It's a little pink one. That's cute. I don't see my poopin' packs though. These aren't Furreals. The Furreals are over here. I don't see poopin' packs. Though he's pretty fun. I like the pet vet costume for Doc. That's really neat. Tegan's preferred mode of transportation now. I saw this infomercial about a backpack that you wear that is for when kids do this, and it straps around their ankles and it straps around the parent's chest, so then you can walk around with your hands free with your kids like that. You're going with Dada? Look at these awesome Dory balloons.
Dory balloon, buddy.
That's so cool.
It can be yours for $6. Wow.
Great.
Check this out. For $40, you can get all 14 The Land Before Time movies.
That'd
17
be like the
hours of dinosaurs.
Yeah.
Here we are at the Merrimack Premium Outlets. We haven't been here in a little while. It probably hasn't been since January, maybe? A little after Christmas?
I don't remember. I don't remember when it was, but it has been a while. And Tegan's taking a nap, so I think I'm going to be carrying him on my shoulders.
She's kind of excited to be doing that. It's been a while since Tegan's rode on her back.
Yeah. But we don't have a lot of time before the birthday party starts at 2, so...
Yeah, it's 12:30 right now. But there's only one store we go into here. It's the outlet store.
Yeah, but we still need to get a present for Emma.
Lots of cars here today. Hopefully we can find a parking spot.
Mm-hmm. That's another reason why I don't want to spend too much time waiting, because it's going to be busy here today.
It's a beautiful day.
Mm-hmm.
Car says it's 86 degrees out.
Holy smokes.
And here we are. We always have to get the big moose.
What's that? The moose.
Yeah.
This is the only way to travel. Off to the Disney store. It's not super crazy busy.
No, not nearly as bad as I thought it was gonna be.
We're here, guys.
Let's see if they have.
Hopefully they have better specials than the other Disney store.
Okay.
Stylish princess hat. I'm thinking I might get this California Adventure hat. Yeah, it's 50% off. The lowest ticketed price brings it to $5. If it rings up at $10, I'm not gonna get it.
this one will be $6.
You want a baby Corella?
No.
I like this too. This is neat. I like it.
And we found Tegan some
water shoes.
Spider-Man water shoes. Like a paperweight.
Yeah. I like the Mickey and the Minnie.
Diamond celebration.
Yeah.
But they're 50% off $25, so that's still a little steep.
This is a nice bag.
Look at that. $12.
Thinking of getting that one?
Yeah, I like that. I
feel like it could be waterproof.
Yeah, I like it. I might get that. I think I'll get this.
Do you want a Mad Hatter hat? Very nice. What do you think of Mama's new hat? Okay, ask Olaf, do you want to build a snowman when you hear the noise, okay?
Do you want to build a snowman?
Oh, look at that. I've been impaled.
Oh, look at the baby spin.
Oh, that's cute.
Press here. I don't think he works. He's not doing anything, but he's adorable.
Oh, he is adorable.
Look at all this Ilana of Avalor stuff is out already. I don't think the movie's out yet.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, this is one of those singing dolls.
Swinging
doll. We're looking forward to seeing this movie.
That's awesome.
But there's a little doll set right there. You guys will have to let us know down in the comments, when's this movie coming out? Oh, check out that plush.
Oh, that's awesome.
Look how much stuff they have. It's like three, look how
three
huge
thingies.
This display is.
I like the little mini, the figures.
We can't review this. We don't know who anybody
no.
is.
I like how glittery they are.
We know Ilana.
Awesome.
I want to go through this thing of shirts, see if there's anything cool in here.
Okay.
This is like the discounted adult shirts. And then we'll head out, Tegan.
Okay.
Then we'll go play. There's a nice play area. And then we're going to snack and then we'll go back to the car. Yeah. Where's Tegan?
I'm playing game.
Are you going to go through the log? Can you go through the log?
Uh-huh.
I'll meet you at the other side. You like going to the log, huh? It's hot out today, huh? Okay, bud, you can go down the slide. You can go down the slide. Ready? Oh, be careful, there's somebody behind you.
I'm right behind you.
Go down the slide, buddy, okay? It's okay. Whoops. Got some pretzel bites and some lemonade. We're gonna have a little snack before we hit the road again.
Yum, yum, yum.
Yum, yum, yum. Gotta try this other one.
Woo, sorry, bub.
Whoa. Bub. Having fun on the playground. It is so hot today. Feels like we are in Florida today.
Mm-hmm. Oh, very hot.
Oh, don't put the whole thing in your mouth. Put it back. Mom can have that one. Have a drink. Have a drink. Yummy lemonade. Tegan, is that lemonade cold? You want your milk? Not a lot of milk left in there. I'm sure Jana has some milk. Take a look at this car, Tegan. Slingshot.
Good luck, bud. Wouldn't that be fun to ride around in?
This is what Ben calls the Batmobile every time she sees one on the road.
I want one.
All right, off to the car. It is roasting today.
Yeah. Whoa, goodness.
So our quick Disney haul, we're back in the car. Ben got this pretty cool mini bag from Disneyland. It was originally $40, marked down to $25, but then it was 50% off this. So it must have been around $12. That's a heavy duty bag. I'm sure you're gonna bring that in some of our travels.
Yes, I am. I'm gonna start using that shortly, I'm sure.
For summertime, we got Tegan the short and tank top set. We got Jake, Captain Jake, and we got Kion over here. These are $10 a piece.
Are these size 4?
Are they? He'll be able to wear them a couple years.
I think they're size 4. That's funny. Yep, size 4. You alright, buddy? Okay. Good, he can wear them for a while. That's awesome. Okay.
Okay, Ben was excited to find this. The 2015 Disneyland sweatshirt.
Yay!
We were looking for this last year. This is similar to our hoodies, but they never released this in the hoodie design.
Yeah.
We have 2014 hoodies like this.
Mm-hmm.
Similar design, but not exactly.
So but I got a 2015 one. It's not hoodie.
No, it was marked down to $9.99, so marked down again. So she got this for $5.
I love it.
And of course, my California Adventure hat was even lower than I expected. It was only $3.49. I'm sure originally this was a $25 hat. What do you want to bet?
Probably. At least.
$19.95, yep. And then we got Tegan some Spider-Man water shoes. Because his other ones are a little tight on his feet.
Well, they're the right size, but they, right under the arches right here, give him blisters. So I don't know. I don't know what it is with them.
So I'm pretty excited. I have a new yard sailing hat here.
Yeah.
Well, we're on our way back home. We didn't film anything at the birthday party just because, you know, we're not familiar with all the people there and we didn't want to be rude by like shoving cameras into places that we shouldn't shove cameras. But Tegan had fun. They had a little wading pool set up, a little kiddie pool. Mm-hmm. So he was all over that. He was the only other kid there. It was mostly
besides
a family party.
Besides the birthday party.
Yeah,
except, girl.
Well, yeah, that's what I said. The only other kid there besides the birthday girl. So he had fun, especially in the pool. Mm-hmm. He had his own cupcake. He got a little Finding Nemo goodie bag for his birthday, late birthday present.
Which works nicely because we got Emma a Finding Dory package for her birthday.
So that was good gift prediction on Ben's part. She was all about Nemo and Dory, so that worked out nicely. And now I'm in the mood to rewatch that movie before we see Finding Dory.
I know.
Just pop it into the player.
Yeah.
I don't know if it'll be tonight because it's 5:30 right now and we're still in New Hampshire. So it's probably going to be closer to 8 by the time we get home.
It takes over 2 hours to get home from where we were. So.
And I don't know if we're going to be making any more stops or not. Probably. Knowing us and our small bladders. It's going south, right?
Yep.
Glad we're not going south. Look at all this traffic. And it's just crawling along. Meanwhile, we're just zipping along.
Yeah, we're just cruising.
Everybody's weekend is over.
Mm-hmm. That is quite the traffic over there.
Stopped off in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, and apparently this Bugaboo Creek is now permanently closed as well. It's right next door to the IHOP we ate at just a couple of weeks ago.
A couple of days ago.
Well, it was a little longer than a couple of days, but...
Wasn't it just last week that we were here?
Was it last week or the week before? It was that day we went to Savers. I remember that, and we went to the mall.
It wasn't that long ago.
And we went to this Toys R Us, which I'm going to run into real quick, because I have some Toys R Us bucks, and this place closes in like 45 minutes. I'm going to see if I can find anything.
There's some clothes for on clearance out on the curb.
Ooh.
You should look through that.
So it turns out this Toys R Us is actually open till 8, not till 7. But there's nothing new in the pony aisle. But they do have a random box of mini Mixie Cues here.
In the set up here.
Oh yeah, I don't think I've ever seen the playset before. They're invading the pony aisle, though.
Oh my god, look how adorable this little playset is. Oh, and you can stack them, just like the My World stuff.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Oh, that's awesome.
Tegan is exhausted. He was waking up in kind of a bad mood, so we took him in with us.
And we've had to distract him with Sheriff Callie. Oh, they have the Squinky Doo drops.
Mm-hmm. And they get the blind packs over there.
Yeah.
I think it's where we saw them the other day, too.
I think so, and we didn't get any.
No, we can get some today because we have some Toys R Us box.
Yeah, let's get some.
Tsum Tsums are buy one, get one 50% off, including the blind bags. Did we complete our series too?
No, we did not.
We should get a couple then.
Yeah. I was looking at the twosies.
Oh yeah, we need some of those as well.
I don't see any blind boxes.
Oh, we missed. Did we miss out?
I don't see any. I just see packages.
Bummer. There's one.
Oh, there's one.
Well, we can have one anyway for our roundup. Yeah, this is I've never seen this series of Minion Surprise before.
What's in it?
Oh. You can get Scarlet Overkill in this one.
Nice.
So we'll have to get a couple of these too.
Yeah.
They're all mixed in with the older one, so I gotta be careful. Did you find Judy?
Here's Nick Wilde.
Wow.
Aww. Yeah. Look at all the Secret Life of Pet stuff. Tons of it.
Yeah.
These are Toys R Us exclusive figure packs right here. Uh-oh.
Clawhauser.
Red Barbie.
Hit the bottom of it.
Yeah.
Hit it.
That.
You get a coin.
Red. Oh, red circle. Oh, gold.
Are you going to get the extra life?
Oh,
Finding Dory and Nemo.
Yep, these are going to be the last two Disney Infinity figures ever. That's kind of sad.
They look really awesome, though.
I've heard that this is a really fun playset.
I can't wait to play it.
And once again, there's the Mad Hatter. That's the only place we've seen him so far. Wish it was a sale of some sort.
I know.
We found a bunch of cool blind bags that we plan to like lump together in one big blind bag special here coming up. We got some Squinky Doo drops, we got some mini Mixie Cues, we got some Tsum Tsums, we got some Minions. What else did we get? I think been through in some Shopkins.
Yep.
Did we get anything else? I don't remember. Oh, we got that one Twosies pack.
Yep.
So that'd be a cool little hodgepodge that we'll get to one of these days. So heading home, I can see the New Hampshire Domain Bridge dead ahead. So it was a super fun day. Thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you tomorrow.